Hello, everyone. Welcome to today's session. We are going to talk about building event-driven applications with Amazon DocumentDB. I'm Saurav Biswas. I'm a senior DocumentDB specialist solution architect here at AWS. I'm based out of Denver, Colorado. And I have with me...
Thanks, Saurav. I'm Karthik Tota. I'm a senior DocumentDB specialist solution architect based out of London. Let's get started.
Thanks, Karthik. So let's go over to just agenda. So today we're going to give you a brief overview of Amazon DocumentDB and then talk about the AWS Lambda event source mapping for Amazon DocumentDB. And then Karthik is going to take over and discuss the open search service integration, which would be an example of event-driven applications built on Amazon DocumentDB. We'll also give you a demo on that. And we are going to conclude it with some resources on what are the next steps for you, where you can read more about it, and where you can find about our future releases. So coming to Amazon DocumentDB is one of our purpose-built database services, and we particularly focus on those use cases which need document data stores. So what makes Amazon DocumentDB unique, right? There are three primary pillars. We are highly scalable, and we have separation of storage and compute. That means we can scale them separately. Compute scales in minutes. Storage and I/O are auto-scaling, so you don't have to even do any operations out there. For instance-based clusters, we can store up to 120 terabytes of data. For elastic clusters, it's 4 petabytes. So a lot of data can be stored here. You could scale out to up to 15 read replicas, and for elastic clusters, 32 shards, which can serve millions of reads and writes. We are also globally distributed for disaster recovery. We are also a fully managed service. That means you don't have to provision any hardware, nor any software, nor maintain them. We take care of your OS patching. We take care of all the knobs and tunes of operations like availability, durability, best practices. These are all built in. We are also MongoDB API compatible. That means all the applications you have now that run on MongoDB, you can use the same code, same drivers, same tools, and start using DocumentDB with little or no changes. Keep in mind though, we do support a lot of the APIs and the operators, but we are also adding the rest of them depending on the market feedback or the field feedback. So we work continually backward from our customers, and whenever a new feature request comes in, we keep bringing in new features. So keep an eye on the release notes to know what's new in DocumentDB. Now, coming to today's topic, event-driven applications. So what drives the framework of event-driven applications? That's AWS Lambda Event Source Mapping. AWS Lambda is one of our primary serverless services. So it gives you ability to run code without upfront provisioning infrastructure. And what is an event source mapping? It's kind of a Lambda resource. If you are familiar with the Lambda screen, it is kind of the trigger button that you click and configure. And it basically is it's kind of a mechanism of invoking the Lambda function whenever an event happens. And in our case, it happens to be Amazon DocumentDB's chain stream. So you can now map Lambda functions to Amazon DocumentDB chain streams. Now, what are chain streams? Again, chain streams are a time-ordered sequence of change events that are happening in your database. So any change of data that may be a delete operation, a write operation, an update operation, all of those are captured in the chain streams. And now with the help of Lambda ESM mapping for chain streams, you can build event-driven applications on top of your Amazon DocumentDB data. And as with Lambda, like any language that's supported in Lambda, you can write your code, your function in that language. So this is how chain streams are kind of populated. Whenever you send a change to your data, for example, in this case, you're updating a collection, the data actually gets modified in the storage layer, as well as chain streams also get accumulated in the storage layer. So keep in mind, when you're updating chain streams, they do go to the storage layer, they do incur I/O and storage. Things to note, you have to enable them They are not enabled by defaults. It's per collection level. You can do it for all collections as well. But keep in mind the cost aspect of it. And also, you could have chain streams retained up to 7 days. The default is 3 hours. And once that's done, you could use Lambda functions to read those chain streams. Now, chain streams can also be read using the API, right? So you could totally not use the ESM or the event source mapping and still read them from the Lambda function, but to have an architecture which periodically polls and sends data down to a downstream service like OpenSearch, like the one we'll be demoing today, you'd have to have a mechanism to trigger the function periodically, usually using an event branch, and then you have to read the events using the API, control the batching aspects of it and how much data you read at a time, etc., as well as save the state of the last processed event. So some kind of like management required for that architecture when ESM did not exist, or if you do not choose to use ESM. With ESM, it's a simplified management. All of the things I mentioned are automatically taken care of. The function is triggered whenever a certain threshold is met, and you are the one who is configuring the threshold. It could be a batch size. It could be a function of time. So you can set a time window, and the function is triggered. And whatever chain streams accumulate, these are all processed, and the Lambda ESM keeps track of the whole state of the last processed events. Now, this is the time I'll have Karthik take over and do his demo as well as his architecture slides.
Thank you, Saurav, for explaining us about Amazon DocumentDB and the Lambda ESM. Now, I'll be talking to you about Amazon DocumentDB and OpenSearch integration. With this integration, you can run full-text queries as well as fuzzy logic queries and some semantic search queries on Amazon DocumentDB data that is streamed to OpenSearch in real time. How do we do it? We do it with the Lambda ESM integration. So for this demo, I'll be using AWS Cloud 9, which is a browser-based terminal from AWS to simulate my application. And in the AWS Cloud 9, I'll be running a script that would be loading a review data, which is an artificial review data, into DocumentDB row by row. And that data is read by Lambda ESM in near real time and would be streamed to Amazon OpenSearch. And Lambda ESM would be reading the data from Amazon DocumentDB chain stream. So we have to enable Amazon DocumentDB chain streams. By default, Amazon DocumentDB chain streams are disabled. And we are using AWS Secrets Manager to store Amazon DocumentDB credentials. Lambda ESM requires AWS Secrets Manager secret for DocumentDB credentials. AWS Secrets Manager helps you. So without any delay, I'll get on to the demo. And before I start, let me tell you, I have launched the infrastructure on AWS, on my AWS account, using AWS CloudFormation template mentioned in this blog. And we have attached this blog in the QR code in the resources section, so you can access this blog details from that. So, and this is my AWS account, and here is my Amazon DocumentDB 4.0 cluster, and here is my DocumentDB secret, and here is my Amazon DocumentDB OpenSearch service, or the Lambda ESM that would be reading the data from chain streams into and streams the data into Amazon OpenSearch. Let's get into a little bit details of this function. It is scripted to create to stream the data into OpenSearch in the index name DocumentDB reviews, and I mentioned the Amazon OpenSearch host in the host details, and it will get from the environment variable. Let's look at the environment variable quickly. Getting into the configuration, environment, and this is my AWS host. The next thing is we have to enable chain streams on Amazon DocumentDB. Let's get into AWS Cloud 9 and log into DocumentDB and show you if there are any databases. It's an empty cluster. I'll just enable Amazon DocumentDB chain streams by using the modify chain streams command, and we have the chain streams enabled. Now let's see if OpenSearch has any indexes. So the Amazon OpenSearch also does, OpenSearch in my account doesn't have any indexes. So everything is clean. Now the next step is we will be creating a trigger on Amazon DocumentDB using the Lambda ESM. So I go to the Lambda and go to the configuration and choose triggers, and I select on to add triggers and choose DocumentDB and choose the DocumentDB cluster. I have one. And for the database name, I choose product review DB. And for the collection name, I use product reviews. And I leave the remaining things default, and I choose the secrets manager, secret, and click on add. Now the trigger got enabled. Let's see the details. So we have the trigger authenticated, and we have the collection name and the database name and the secret, all the values that we have set while creation of the trigger. Now let's get into Cloud9 and start implementing the loader. Now it is now the loader started inserting row by row. Let's see the database in DocumentDB. See, we have got the product review DB in the DocumentDB. It means the data is in the DocumentDB. And let's also see if we have the DocumentDB reviews index created on Amazon OpenSearch. We can see the DocumentDB reviews index created on OpenSearch. I want to find out the reviews that are having the text easy to use in the large review text. And also, this review should be having a star rating which are more than 4. So this is easy to use, and it has a review star rating more than 4, which is here, the star rating is 5. Now, let me run fuzzy search queries. A fuzzy search query searches for the text that matches a term closely instead of exactly. So I want to not filter out the queries that are not sounding like easy because it is not spelled as E-A-S-Y. So if you look at it, it has given me the queries that are having review body having EASY, even though I mentioned that give me the queries that are having EASY, but I mentioned it as fuzzy in the query. And the last one, I want to show you a boost query where you can prioritize few. In this boost query, I want to find out the reviews that are having the game mentioned in the review body on the top than the queries that are having the game mentioned in the review title. I am asking OpenSearch to give me the queries that are having game in the review body prioritized than having the word query in the product title. And because I mentioned it to boost the review body by 2, there would be a score that would be assigned to each and every query result. And what is the max score? 9.70. So because it is mentioned in the game review body as well as in product title, it is on the top. So this is how you can run fuzzy logic search, full text search, and boost search queries on Amazon DocumentDB data that is streamed to OpenSearch. Over to you, Saurabh.
Thanks, Karthik, for the wonderful demo and the architecture. I hope our audience learned a lot from this and really looking forward to hearing back from them. So before we conclude, let's look at some resources, right? How do you get started? If you're interested in this architecture, want to try it out, you can always use our free tier. You could get 750 hours of T3 medium instance. So that's a decent size for your development activities. You get 5 GB of storage, 30 million IOPS, and 5 GB of backup, right? So all of this is free for a month. Go use it, try out the solution we just talked about. And additionally, there's a blog that discusses this process in detail. You can find it on the QR code on the left side of the screen. And then we have more resources like the release notes we talked about. We talked about the documentation. So tons of resources available for you. Just look up the QR code on the right side of the screen. And do reach out back to us. There are different channels you can reach out to us. And waiting to hear back from you. Thank you so much for today's session.